you said after you were dismissed, you gave information to a friend mm-hmm. so that friend could get that information into the public media.
Correct.
What kind of information was that? What kind of information did you give to a friend?
That the Flynn conversation, that the president had asked me to let the Flynn, I mean, I'm forgetting my exact own words, but the conversation in the Oval Office.
So you didn't consider your memo or your sense of that conversation to be a government document? You considered to be somehow your own personal document that you could share with the media as you wanted to?
Correct.
Through a friend?
I understood this to be my recollection recorded of my conversation with the president. As a private citizen, I felt free to share that. I thought it very important to get it out.
So were all of your memos that you recorded on classified or other documents, memos that might be yours as a private citizen?
I'm sorry, I'm not following the question.
Well, I think you said you'd use classified.
Not the classified documents. Unclassified. I don't have any of them anymore, but I gave them to the special counsel. But yeah, my view was that the content of those unclassified, the memorialization of those conversations was my recollection recorded.
So why didn't you give those to somebody yourself rather than give them through a third party?
Because I was worried the media was camping at the end of my driveway at that point, and I was actually going out of town with my wife to hide, and I worried it would be like feeding seagulls at the beach if it was I who gave it to the media. So I asked my friend, make sure this gets out.
It does seem to me that what you do there is create a source close to the former director of the FBI as opposed to just taking responsibility yourself for saying, here are these records. Like everybody else, I have other things I'd like to get into, but I'm out of time.